friends, welcome back to my channel. I'm Renuka and this is the unboxing of Hero Arts kit. And somehow I'm a little bit late on my card making videos. I didn't yet post the last month's kit video, but still I want to share some ideas, cause as my kit arrived, some of other kits also arrived at some of places. So let's see. This kit is quite a nice and bigger one, cause I like really the stamp and dies, and they have lots and lots of Christmas dies. Means if you have this set, I don't think so you're gonna need another Christmas stamp this year, cause this is awesome one. And okay, I'll tell you. And they have this is, I think, sold out. As always, these sold out pretty fast. So in this kit, you will get this full set of stamps, some dies, and in dies there are three specialty dies. One is kind of cityscape, one is mountain range, other is the tree range. And for these matching dies, you will get a Santa and Mrs. Santa die. Then you will get this station one. You're gonna get this small house, the ginger house one, and this house, and another you're gonna get the shell out of I think, yeah, it's you will get these girl and the fox or horse there, this stamp, and one clock tower, a Christmas tree, and some of the smaller ones like the one of the these Christmas trees and all. And for other small images, they don't have the stamp. I think the one is for slate one. This is slate. And for other like this elves and the small boxes, this girl, the penguins, these animals, the small mountain, seashell, this girl, they don't have the dies, matching dies with it, like with these small choo-choo train, kind of Santa Claus train, and this horse. But these are pretty small, and igloo also. These are pretty small images, so you can accomplish a lot of them in a small card base. The same time, you can create a small tags with it. And this kit can you can incorporate with any snow globe die if you have the snow globe die. If you are a subscriber of Hero Arts kit, so last year they have the snow globe die and all the same. You can definitely fit all of the images in them. And these are pretty small images, so don't have to color them much. You need a really fine tip marker. There is no much chance to, you know, give a shading or something like that. They have the six specialty papers, this two, and this like stone or kind of snow kind of thing, so you can cut the mountains from them. Two glittery papers, you can do anything with them, like the mountains, or you can add the sentiment on them. And for this specialty paper, you can color it with the rainbow thing, like with the distress inks, or you can add a couple of colors, whatever you want, with the distress oxide or distress inks. And you can create some traditional and non-traditional backgrounds with this, and you can just decorate out the small images from this and put them. The same time, they have the lots of sentiments, like the pose from the greetings from the North Pole, from all of us, the Christmas time, happy holidays, Merry Christmas, Santa works, elves at work, and this is the season, so Santa's workshop. So excuse me, lots of sentiments in there. A silver glitter embossing powder, one white unicorn white ink of Hero Arts, and this is the pen, and one of the sleeker pen. It's like a little bit of glossy accent and kind of giving a snowy kind of liquid color to it, little bit of shine. And we'll work with this also, and white unicorn ink, basically for like creating the snow mountains and everything. Like this have the small snowflakes and small stars also to create the background of the it. And after this, I'll a little bit speed up the process, and I will show you what's in the kit and how you can incorporate this. Basically, this kit is all about the stamping and creating a nice background scenes with it. So basic idea of this kit is that, and the small tags, it's gonna fit with the lawn phones tags or Samus's tags or any tags you have. And if you don't have the tags, you can create your own tags by adding just a one hole punch hole, and you can create that. Because these small images like this elves, the small things, and this gift bag, the horse, the baseball bat, the ball, some kind of tools there, so you can create a very pretty custom greetings with them. This, you can have the Santa with Mrs. Santa with the pie. There is some small pie, lots of trees, lamps, so you can create a night scene, day scene, any kind of scene with it. And the simple thing, if you don't want to create the scene, you can create a small background paper with it by stamping any of these images like this elves or these gifts or the car, the Santa and the Mrs. Santa, or you can combine them and just stamp them and color them, and you will get a one layer nice card with this. You can create all the snowy scenes with this. They have a little bit of wave also for this water boat and some fish and penguins also, so you can create that also and put the North Pole greetings there. Same times you can add these Santa sleigh and reindeer, and you can create, stamp them multiple times and create that scene also. You can create a train station scene here, and another is like elf at work, so they are working and you can create a small scenes with them. These are pretty cute. In fact, the add-ons are also cute, but I didn't order add-ons because most of the times I don't have time to work with only these kids, so add-ons I don't think so I have that much time. And then another thing you can do with this kit is like these are pretty small images, so these are kind of fun. But what you can do, you can stamp all the scene and you don't put the colors on them, and you put a little crayons or little pencils, the cheap one, with them, and you can give the recipient so they can color them out. Or you can just create a simple cards with the nice backgrounds. And yeah, possibilities are endless. This kit, you can get a ton and ton of cards with it. So I'll just speed up the process. So now it's time for the ideas, and what I did is just by coloring these images, I have an idea that I have the die cuts of only these images, not all of them, so I can create a mask accordingly, or I can just plan my whole scene accordingly. And then there are three specialty dies coming with it, and I cut out some paper with that, although I'm not putting the card together today. I just put some watercolor on this paper and then add little bit of some snowflakes there. And this is kind of acting like the mountain. As it becomes a mountain, then cut out some from the green one. And then this city die, the city line die from the silver one. All these papers communicate, not the green one. So you can get an idea. And then I cut out a couple of images and color them. While coloring them, you have to remember that these are pretty small images, and the nib of your alcohol marker is little bit like more not thin, so it may occur that sometimes the color may go here and there. So you need to do a little bit of practice there. And now you can put this scene, all scene together, and just stamp the any sentiment, the holiday or Christmas or anything from here, the happy holidays, and that will give you the card. Another thing what I noticed from this specialty papers and card is these all are 5x7. So this is the standard A7 cardstock, and it's nice to see it create a scene with the more space in there, so it will not look like very clumsy or hodgepodge if you want to create the full train station scene there, because it will give a more room to put all the things together. Like I said before, you can put all this stuff together and put a railway near at the bottom of the cardstock, so it's gonna cover the whole thing. Before cutting your specialty paper, you should also remember that these are 5x7 papers, so you can act accordingly for them before cutting. So I got an idea that how I will do one of the cards with the specialty paper is I just cut out one star from, and this is Civic Star, the biggest one I have. You can use any one you have, and then I just put this paper. I can put this paper all around the image, but before that I can color all this in the distress ink or any alcohol marker in the rainbow fashion, so the all things are in rainbow in color, and then I can put my images inside just like that, kind of tugging there and creating my small scene. Or I can just put this star, and then I put all the scenes on in front of them. So everything is everything else is colorful, so that star gonna stand out more nicely. Another thing I do before starting my cards, that I cut out the specialty paper, and for alcohol markers I use the Spectrum Nora alcohol markers, but you can use the Nina Solar. And for the watercolor paper, mostly I use the Smirnoff or the Canson watercolor paper. So I just cut out couple of 5x7 cardstock in hand, so it's easier to, you know, use this size and create everything and then directly stick to on your card base if you are making 5x7 and if you are interested in making that kind of scene creating things. Another thing is that I would love to show you that I create this long train, and I'm gonna put the small things like this toy, this doll, some sort of gifts on these in between trainers compartments, and that's gonna look a nice kind of toy train kind of look or Christmas train kind of look. And I can create anything else in the upper side. Now rather than putting these dies directly on this, I can use some of the rough papers and create this kind of rect outs, and then kind of taking my sponge dauber or the ink dauber, and then I can smoosh it the ink, so it will give me the affected green trees there kind of masking. I can do same thing for the clouds also. I can put this the dye for mountains also. I can put this and just give a little bit of blue blush there, so I can just shift this dye because it not is long enough like the 7, but what is the nice thing, it can cover the small A2 size card, and like this it can cover the small A2 size card because this is the A2 size, and it can cover the 5x7 the vertically. So that is the nice long die thing I can say about it. Another thing is I would like to do, love to do, is these small images I can stamp in multiple times, and I can heat emboss them, and then I can just put little bit of color of polished color or the watercolor, or I can use the pencils to color them. So I'll heat emboss those, and I can do the small things with those. Now these small critters and images you can add in the nice small things. I just stamp a small example where I stomp this little elves, they are kind of working, and kind of I use directly the watercolor. It's kind of a printed watercolor paper, but you can create your own, or if you want to make the fastest tags, you can use these images are pretty small, so you can accomplish them in a lawn font tag die also, because these are pretty small images, so you have those images in those dies. and you know, you can see that I have this watercolor tag and I'm planning to work on this. But before that, I want to show you that how this small image is gonna, now you can put these small girls and heels and you can create a nice scene. In fact, you can put this in front of it and you can stamp something here, so possibilities are endless. You can create the tag as well as you can create some kind of shaker window to it. And if you have the last year's kit, that this kit is the last year and they have the snow globe and little bit of the same shell out of the Santa and small images like the trees, you can use and incorporate those images in a kind of combination with those and you can create a nice scene. So I'm planning to create a circular card and I will stamp all this small igloo and this small mountain and the seashell and the small penguin, all the small critters, and this girl is fishing, something like that, and that kind of give me a nice thing. Again, these are the ideas. I'm still not started my working process. I just want to show you that how it's gonna work. So this is the die. I always make a stencil and I keep that in the same pocket. So now you can see that how that image is kind of fitted in that snow globe. If you don't have that year's kit, last year kit, you can go ahead and purchase the another one, or you can use your circle die and just snip off the bottom to create the snow globe, and you have to create this by the help of something else. So this is, like, you can see that this girl is nicely fitting in that. You can create a nice card with her, like this slate and the small things, the Christmas tree, lots of things. You can get the Santa workstation, so you can do lots of cards with this kit. And this kit also came with the dies. You can use those dies also, some mountains and hills things. So that is the another possibility. And if you have the MFT fan, then you must have the blueprint 32 or 27 die. I always have this. I really like that to create the shaker cards, and I'm planning to put those small elves there and color them individually and kind of putting some of these gifts and one of these trees like this. So that kind of create a really nice small card. Another thing, if you have the Hero Arts or anyone else tag thing, so you can do that. I have this mason jar tag, so I'm planning to do some tags with the small Santa and Mrs. Claus is there. There's some small igloo, the people are singing something, a song there, the small snowman is there, small fox is there. So you can put anything there, two or three maybe, and that's gonna like awesome tags for your gifts. And what you can do, you can just stamp couple of them, put in your bag, and just put some kind of colors like the green, yellow, red, and kind of blue, and that's gonna awesome. And you can just play with them, and you can you know, color them on the way, on the go, and that gonna give you a nice bunch of tags while at the end of the things. Another thing I have in my mind is kind of creating scene with this Merry Christmas. I have this die with the Samuses. I love this die, and if you watch before, I use this die at the before series also, and I would love to stamp this and create the shaker card with it. Or I can just stamp all the images here and put everything in behind and color it, and this is the watercolor card. So I love to do that. This die also came with the small dies like this, and this is the die. This is the die, and cut out like this with the snowflakes at the side. And you can again create a card with a couple of things here by the putting these images inside it, and it gonna looks really awesome because these are pretty small images, so that gonna fit in any kind of these kind of dies you have in your stash. Just go ahead and see what you have in your stash, so you get a couple of ideas with it. Another thing I want to do with this kit is you can create the scenes, you can create the tags, or you can directly stamp these images on the directly colored paper, and you can cut out them and put them, or you can just remember which one is. I saw this kind of idea on the blog hop, I think. there, where is the she put this red color and yellow, but I really like that idea that you can stamp a couple of images on the colored paper and everything else on the white paper and put those. So yeah, I give that credit to the blog hopper one. I don't remember the name, but yeah, I want to give the credit to that one. I really like that idea. And another thing is what you can do with all these small elf is you can put a circular shape and you can just stamp all of them in a circular fashion, and then you can just stamp your Santa or elves at Merry Christmas in between, and that gonna give that those elves are like all around the earth. Or you can color this small circle as earth in a blue and green, or you can just put it little bit of gold embossing powder and put all the elves all around it and put the background in red, or this in red and everything in white. That gonna also work. You can try some traditional or non-traditional coloring methods here. I have lots of kind of tried little bit of color combinations here, and maybe I'll use some of them. I already colored some of them, so maybe I'll plan to use them. Red and green and blues are really the Christmas colors, so you can go ahead with that. And another thing I really want to do is these guys are singing some kind of things, and this is Christmas songs, so I want to stamp them in a row and in the full, and by heat emboss them in a golden color, and I want to put them in a kind of a red and green pattern. So what I'm planning to do is I don't know how much time I will get, but yeah, so if this is your card base, you can put a little strips of here green and red, and after that you can stamp these small in the peoples in the line, and 1, 2, 3 line, and you can stamp your Christmas greetings here, and then you can stamp another one on the white one, fuzzy cut out them and stick them above your greeting. So that gonna also give a nice effect. You can do same thing for this Santa and Mrs. Claus that she is holding a pie, and but for the all the other things, you can just put these elves and small trees and gifts and everything else. Yeah, just heat emboss them and only color these two. That gonna also work really nice. You can put this choo-choo train all around like the circle, like I told you about the elves one. That also give a really nice and different look to your card. Another thing I want to do with this card is this, like the small toys, like this girl, the gift, the horse, and this gift thing. You can put all those on just behind your Christmas tree or in front of your Christmas tree by masking them and coloring them. And if you don't want to go like the really smart at seeing work, you can just stamp them, then fuzzy cut out them, and you can stamp them like this here, like the gift one, something. And then you need to just cut out these area and cut out the whole circle in the partial die cutting, and you can create a shaker card here, and you can put the Christmas tree behind inside the shaker one, and you can stamp here inside or outside the yours heat embossing transparency. So that also give a nice look here. You can do the same idea with these elves, small elves, and this girl with the fox, and this reindeer also. So or you can put all these things in front of like this tower, the station, and the train here, and you can create that shaker card also. So possibilities are endless. You can create a full shaker card that you can create. You can just put the train here and in front of your shaker full window, and just put all the scene behind inside the card, and put little bit of snowflakes or glitter dust will gonna work really nice for this one, and that also gonna work really nice. And maybe I'll come out with some different ideas while I'm making the card. I don't know how many cards I'm gonna make, depends on time permitted me. But I hope you like this video, you enjoyed it, and if you like it, give it thumbs up, leave some comments so I can more improve myself or kind of giving more ideas to you. And if you didn't subscribe, if you like my channel, subscribe to it. You can follow me on my social media. So until the next crafty project, have a crafty life. Bye bye.